What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Let's play Sonic Adventure 2, Part 6. We are in the Chow Garden again, and I just wanted to look at Knuckles really quickly, because now that I have the shovel claws, the hammer gloves, the air necklace, and the sunglasses is the last thing you can find, and it is the second optional item. You don't, you know, for story completion, if you're just going after the story, you don't need it. Same with the air necklace. It just makes it, you know, the sunglasses you need for the hard mode.
Long time no see, treasure hunter. Did you find my emerald?
That's a good one, your emerald. Talking to you is a waste of time.
And the air necklace just helps you with...
Very well. If that's how you want to play, I will take it from you.
It just helps you in the final level of the game when you play it as Knuckles. Actually, I think I needed to try to almost pin her in a corner and, like, there we go. Try to do that. Because that didn't work. But you can see, you know, this is the meteor herd, the central area where I was. Where's she went? She's either, oh, there she is. Now, if she gets above you, she will try to drill down into you, but, you usually don't have as much trouble with her. Honestly, she's actually a fairly easy boss fight. I like Shadow. I guess she can't even get up there. It's hard to keep track of her because the camera really doesn't work with you. I guess you can just kind of punch her repeatedly. That'll work. There we go.
I never lose.
Get away from my emerald.
So I guess if you just repeatedly attack her, that works. Instead of trying to get above her and, like, drill down into her or anything like that.
Stop fooling around and give me back my emerald.
What are you babbling about? Call yourself a hunter attacking a lady? Shame on you!
What kind of lady goes around stealing gems anyway?
Those belong to me!
What in the world?
Keep your hands to yourself!
Is that how you say thanks to someone who just saved your life?
Saving my life? Don't think I owe you one. You just wanted to hold my hand, didn't you? That's why you saved me, Mr. Decree.
This isn't a joke, you can't. Think what you want, Batgirl. I was saving the Master Emerald.
No matter what you say, it sounds crazy.
What?
Fine, then just take them. They stink like echidnas do.
If that's what you thought, you should have given me them in the first place. Finally.
What?
I'm sorry if I hurt you.
We should get going.
And that was the last Knuckles level in the game. I think Tails' level was the last Tails level, at least for the story, I guess, in the game, but the story mode, really. Just level-wise, I think there is one more boss fight that you fight as Tails with.
Tails and Amy are in danger! Hurry, Sonic!
And this is another hard level to get to.
There are some robots that look like research projects.
This is another level that's hard to get the A rank for because it's very easy to die in this level if you're not careful. And just because you have to get get it time based is really slows it down, the fact that it's more time based than score based. And this is where you can get a Sonic upgrade that is story based, that you actually need to get. And of course, if you go into that green liquid, you will die, so you want to be careful. I think I just messed up. Yep. Goes at 3,660 points. Can't believe I did that, honestly. Played this level enough to know that I know the right way to go. But then, that's what I'm talking about. It's just so easy to die here if you're not careful. And of course, if you lose your rings, you won't get any points for grabbing them again, so there's really no reason. Of course you need the rings, but don't do it for the point aspect of it, because you won't get any points. Ah, crap. Yeah. That's one thing that I hate about getting the, That's one thing I hate about getting the bounce bracelet. It makes using light speed dash a lot harder. The bounce bracelet is, I think that's an upgrade that you have to get. I don't think you could take the game without it. I'm pretty sure anyway. I got one anyway. That upgrade should be around here somewhere. I guess I'm not quite far enough yet. Ah, there it is, okay. It says the flame ring. This allows you to use a powerful fire somersault, which will allow me to break the metal crates. It doesn't matter if I break these now or not. I didn't even need to break all of them. I just needed to break the one in the middle so I can somersault through. I'm not sure if I would have or not, but if you don't know for sure, it's usually best not to light speed dash and with an enemy around. Maybe it's a little bit of a shortcut as well, but I'm not sure how much of one.
Emergency! Emergency! Well done, Sonic, but you'll never leave this room alive! Haha!
Yeah, this one's a pain to get through as well. This particular room, because you have to keep changing the gravity and making sure that you can hang on to the grab on here and get to the different platforms. I guess it's not that dangerous, not as dangerous as doing something like this, but you always want to be careful doing the light speed dash around bottomless pits and things like that. Now hitting that switch is, it was the main goal of doing this. It also allows me around, but if you didn't hit that switch, you wouldn't have been able to open that rocket, which wouldn't have been able to, and you have to do that entire area over again. You have to go back, retrace your steps all the way through. Now, if I hadn't died, I probably would have ended up getting the, I'd have 16,000 instead of 13,000.
Just made it.
But, still did okay, score-wise. I ended up getting a C, but like I said, that one's kind of difficult, because you can die very easily, and if you die, pretty much any level that you die, that kind of ruins your chance to get an A rank, but that level in particular.
Let's take care of business first, shall we, Sonic? Hand over the Chaos Emerald, slowly, and then we'll talk about your girlfriend. That is, if you really care for her.
Handing over the fake emerald? I can kill two birds with one stone!
Big-time villain, Doctor!
Whoa! You thought you could trick me with that fake emerald, didn't you?
So, how did you know it wasn't the real one?
Tails!
Because you just told me, Fox Boy. Now, for a little space ride.
I'm counting on you, Tails. Maybe take care of yourself.
Farewell, Sonic the Hedgehog.
Sonic! It has the same wavelength and properties, but it's less powerful than the real one.
Same wavelength and properties. But can I do this?
Farewell, my admirable
adversary.
Now we have some unfinished business to take care of. If you give me the real emerald, I will release you both. You have my promise.
Sonic asked me for the first time to do something for him. I won't let him down. I won't give up.
And so this is the final Tails thing we get to do in the game with Knuckles is the Knuckles last boss fight. But Robotnik's gonna be a lot harder. He'll actually have a lot of his upgrades if you don't have the upgrades on him. His egg walker. His egg walker. Has that. that armor, like that red plating on it, which is an armor upgrade that I think only Robotnik can get. And that's pretty much what it is. It's an armor upgrade. And this laser that he's shooting is actually a two-player battle item. Rouge will do the same thing. If you give, you know, if you wait long enough, she will use a you can actually damage him with the explosion, and that rocket is the same thing as a oven. It's a two-player battle. Play battle thing. He's hitting you with his melee attack. It's actually a very difficult boss fight, honestly. I'm sure I'm not doing it right. I'm trying to get to him. I'm getting it too close. I think I am getting too close to what I thought. Finally. So I guess the best thing would be to try to stay out of his laser, and if you can't, just try to stay away from him so that he doesn't, like, melee attack you. And just hope he uses the rocket instead of the...
I feel some strange energy.
If I can pull that one off, somehow I managed to use the chaos control.
Chaos control? Are you okay?
I'm worried about Tails and Amy. I hate to ask, but could you help them? This is our last chance. I got it. Before the cannon fires, I'll slam dunk it in there.
And this is the final level for the, I guess, the final stage for... since it says first mission, so I wasn't sure if I actually said that or not. But, right, so this is the final stage. So the final stage in the hero story and the final stage in Sonic. And definitely one of the hardest... I'm not sure if it's the longest, but it's definitely the hardest. I don't need to do the chow, since I'm going to, this will be the last, like, I'll end this video fighting the game. Yeah, if you notice the rails down there, you can actually jump off, like, as soon as you hit this rail on top, you can jump all the way down, and then you can get onto this rail that I'm on right now, and it saves you a little bit of time, you know, you can jump from the rail, and try to get some rings, different things like that, but to try to get an A ring, that's simply the best thing to do, but it doesn't latch, like, you don't automatically latch onto the rails when you jump from rail to rail, and just from that height, like you can see, I kind of have to angle the rail myself to, angle Sonic to the rail himself. I can't just make him, or like I said, the game doesn't automatically target the rail for you, so you need to be very careful if you do try it. But if you're very good at it, you can pull it off. It's definitely a very good way to try to get some time, and you'll actually gain quite a bit of time. Not just a little bit. Oh, I guess I wasn't actually sure if you could do that in this game. I guess you can, crap, I'm trying to get away from you. Beat those things. Not sure if this is the right one or not. Yeah, it is. I didn't actually realize you could jump from rail to rail in this game. I know you can in other Sonic games that have the rail system, but I didn't realize you could do it in this game. That definitely hurt not having that 100 and some rings that I had, but...
Get more speed using jump down. Try grinding up the steep incline. It's fun.
But, yeah, well. You also want to be very careful using the homing attack around here because you can very easily fall off, you know, and overshoot and fall off. If you hold the jump button down, you can actually kind of get a little bit height. Yeah, you have to be very careful doing that. Careful going around on these rails. Always want to make sure the camera's centered wherever you're going. Whenever you're in that section. You never want to try that. It does take a lot of practice to do what I just did, but if you can get the hang of it, it definitely saves you quite a bit of time. So I think it's the orange one I need to go to. It definitely saves you quite a bit of time when you're... Yeah, just then you overshoot. And then you follow this path and you can get an upgrade that will allow you to... For Sonic, I think it's the final upgrade for him. No, actually, it's not the final upgrade, but it's just an optional upgrade for the story, but if you want to get it for, you know, for the third mission in each level, it's the Mystic Melody. Change to Mystic Melody in the action window, then press the circle button to play Mysterious Melodies, which all that does is just allow you to get into these, you know, you walk up to these temples, and usually it, like right now, this will allow me to continue on in the level, but what it would normally do is it would take me to where the lost challenges each level. And each character does have that. I'm not sure if I can get it for every single character without, you know, like having different upgrades and things like that, because like with Tails, I needed to have an upgrade to get it in. I believe it was Robotnik's base. I'm trying to find the entrance to Robotnik's base. It was that level, and I needed a super upgrade to be able to break the metal crates that I needed to get into there. So I don't know if I'll show it off or not. You know, like how to get to it or not. I might just mention it in the wrap-up video. But I'll definitely try to get it from the character that I can. Like Shadow, I can get it from him.
Yeah.
I think that's about it, though. I think Knuckles, Rouge, Robotnik, and Tails, you all needed to have upgrades to be able to get to it.
Huh. No problem.
Going after the Mystic Melody definitely, you know, took quite a bit of time, and that definitely affected my score. And also because I was taking it kind of cautious. But like I said, if you can try to, you know, use momentum as much as you can, that definitely helps you out quite a bit.
You never cease to surprise me, Blue Hedgehog. I thought that capsule you were in exploded in space.
You know, what can I say? I die hard. You actually saved me, you know.
It was a Chaos Emerald, wasn't it? But there's no way you could have activated the Chaos Control using an emerald that's fake. So, there's more to you than just looking like me. What are you, anyway?
What you see is what you get. Just a guy that loves adventure. I'm Sonic the Hedgehog!
I see. But you know, I can't let you live. Your adventure days are coming to an end.
And so this is supposed to be the final boss fight for the hero story, which actually this...
Before this is over, I'll show you the true power of chaos control!
I actually think Tails' boss fight is a lot harder than, crap, this one. This one just is kind of time consuming, but it's not necessarily difficult. Like you can, if you can get it just perfect, you can like high speed dash right through him. You can get it, you can get it, just get the timing down just perfect. Have him pop up, you know, in a line of rings. Or you can just, you know, immediately only attack him, but you have to be careful because the platform, you know, the platform that you're standing on will fall out from underneath you. It's actually a great way to farm rings. This boss fight isn't necessarily that difficult, and if you're decent at it, you can actually sit here and run through here and get a lot of rings doing this. Sitting here continuously using light speed dash on rings. Come on. But you don't want to be careful. You don't want to give him too much room in front of you because he will use a two-player move called Chaos Spear. You know, you can just sit there and kind of spam the homing attack over and over again. It's actually pretty simple, you know, and it makes it a lot easier. You don't necessarily want to do it when he has a lot more health.
Sonic, I did it!
Awesome job, Tails!
Sonic!
And that's how it ends, pretty much. I guess that is how it ends, at least the hero story. You know, there's also the dark story, and there's a final story. I don't remember which is supposed to be the true story. It's not necessarily like a true story, it's just like the one side's events through the game, not necessarily like the hero side story is the true story, it's just what they were doing while Dark Side was doing this and that kind of stuff. The Dark Story does give a little bit of background as to like why the game events happen, but it pretty much that's it. You know, it's just kind of like I said, it's just like the hero story, like the hero side, what was going on in the game, and the Dark Side is really no true story, and the final story is a true story, of course, but not right now. But anyway, so I really don't have a whole lot, you know, like to say about the game, because the game right now, I love the game, you know, great game, but I'll wait until wait until the final story to really get my thoughts about the game, because both the gameplay for both the light side or the hero side and the dark side are pretty much the same. Like Shadow plays like Sonic does, Robotnik plays like Tails does, Rouge plays like Knuckles does, you know. Gameplay wise, but of course the levels are going to be different. But yeah, so that's really all I have to say about it, honestly. Honestly, you know, I'll have to wait until the final story to really get my thoughts about the game. But I'm going to go ahead and end the video here, or you know, of course after the credits. I think you'll watch it next time. We'll begin the Dark Side story, and we'll go through that, you know, all the way, kind of like just like I did with the hero story and everything. So until then, let it go on.
Eggman steals the research from a military base located on an island to the south. The military's top secret weapon, Shadow. Sealed in the space colony Ark, the 7 Chaos Emerald. When all of the keys have been collected, world conquest will be at hand. Sonic Adventure 2, The Dark Side Story. Long live the Eggman Empire.